All right, we are back in the vehicle. And remember how in my last video I said that they invited me to the field? Well, that's what I'm doing now. It's about a 30-minute drive or so, so I'm not going to record the whole thing like I did for the other video, but I've got Micro Monster and the Spectre Nick Maxwell edition with me. I didn't feel like packing a bunch of crap in the car, so I just brought those two. So it's going to be a remaiden'd of the Micro Monster with the new paint scheme that I did. We'll see if those colors are too dark or not. They probably will be, but anyway, I will see you when I get there.
20 minutes later.
So yeah, this is the field here. It's Lake Jacomo is like right over there, I believe. It's actually a pretty popular field. I have never came because it's primarily an airplane field. And I think that might be for helicopters over there. I don't know. I've never been here before, but that would be my guess. Well, like 7 or 8 people just showed up all of a sudden. The sky is amazing. Should be a good day. Except for that one. I pointed up.
Yeah, you must have a lot of expo in that, right?
Yeah, fair bit.
You better touch those sticks; it moves. Not even half. Like I said. Doesn't take much. Put you out of sight there. You gotta get you a different car. I think the real problem is seeing it.
Yeah.
I mean, you have to keep it close enough that you can see it. Or remember which way you're going.
I like the sound.
Yeah.
The whistle. So I'm in my lowest rates right now. I think that's 50%.
Pretty slick. Pretty slick.
Pretty fast. Let's fly the sphincter. This is, like I said, this is technically an airplane field, but as long as there's nobody else flying and not a whole lot of people here, they don't mind if you fly a helicopter over here. That's the consensus I've been given anyway.
Right,
throttle hold.
So we've got some control line going.
That's up, isn't it?
I've never seen this before, so. We're having a great time out here. Great weather. Bunch of guys. Some airplanes. Some helicopters. Some more airplanes. Some turbines.
To the tree, it's 1100.
Some 3D planes.
No, I don't know. I can look
and see. Got the Micro Monster powered back up. Ready to fly it whenever the flight line's clear. All right, round two.
Take your time. See how it goes to it.
RSSI low warning.
Why? It'll slow down nice and good.
What?
It slows down pretty well.
Yeah. I feel like I can see it a little bit better.
That's full, yeah.
Thing zips, I'll tell you that. Like a little mosquito. Dan.
Good old generator's run out of fuel, so gotta go get some more. Otherwise, I'm out of batteries. Got my Mike McFarlane. I think it's like a velocity. It's got an X where the C would normally be. Oh, it's really quick, you might see it. starting to get a little too windy for me to want to fly the Micro Monster again. It's really starting to pick up, so I'm just going to fly the Spectre for now. I'm happy with the result of the airplane. Flies great. But I don't want to push my luck trying to fly in this wind, even though it would handle it. I don't know if I would. So
I would just think that the downside on it would be a little bit too much. What's the downside? Fuel?
Spectre one more time. It's starting to get cold, so I'm packing up now. Had a good time today. Quite enjoyed it. Awesome field. I'll probably come back at some point.
Recovered it. And then did the sealer coat, and then the color coat. And I didn't like the color coat. It wasn't good.
Well, I ended up staying way later than I planned on, but I had a good time, and I'll probably be coming back here a few times because it was great. Plane's fun, Micro Monster, very, very quick, and flew great. It flies like a simulator, practically. It's completely locked in, so very happy with that. I didn't even use the gyro. I turned it off because it flies just fine without it. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.